This is a Friday Shoes production. You can find this in lesson 6-4 in our books on page 320. Our target, I can identify congruent polygons. Well, first of all, polygons that have the same size and shape are called congruent polygons. Congruent is really the geometric symbol or equivalent to the equal sign in algebra. And an example of that is, this is the actual symbol. It looks almost like the equal sign, has a little squiggly on top. We use that in geometry to show equality. So here, in words, if two polygons are congruent, their corresponding sides are congruent and their corresponding angles are congruent. And we designate that in a picture by showing or using arcs for angles and tick marks for sides. So, for instance, hopefully you can see this. You see A here has one arc, so does F. So we would say that A is, or angle A is congruent to angle F. And so on and so forth here. You can see B would be congruent to G, angle G. Also works with sides. If you look at the sides here, I'll just use the one that has one tick mark. We have GH and BC. So you would see that GH and BC are congruent, those line segments, meaning have the same length. And they have the other congruent pieces together as well. Let's talk about writing a congruent statement, or what is a congruent statement. Well, in a congruent statement, the letters identifying each polygon are written so that the corresponding vertices appear in the same order. Order matters. For example, for the diagram below, write, and you can take a look at the triangles there, here's what you could write. Triangle CBD is congruent to triangle PQR. And here's why. Once you write this first one, you have it already set as to how you have to write the second one. Notice you wrote down C first. That means that it has to match up with P over here, because that, or those two are congruent. So notice how P comes first. Same with B here. Wrote B, well, what does that match up with? It matches up with Q. And you can see that one has two arcs. And then, of course, our last one here is D and R. Those go together. So the order matters. Once you say CBD, then you have PQR. You have to put it in that order. Kind of explains it right here. It says two polygons are congruent if all pairs of corresponding angles are congruent and all pairs of corresponding sides are congruent. You might call it just the same or equal, and that's, again, congruent in geometry. Let's take a look at our first example here. It says determine whether the triangles shown are congruent. If so, name the corresponding parts and write a congruent statement. Well, I do notice here that we have some arcs. So I got like X has one arc that matches up with M. I've got Y has two marks, or two arcs, and then N has two arcs. And L has three arcs, and Z has three arcs. Now let's check out our sides. In between the red and the blue here, you see how I've connected these red and the blue? That's XZ. That would match up with LM, and they both have 4 centimeters. That's good. And then how about green to blue? And green to blue? Oh, good. That's 9. That works out. They're the same length. And then how about red and green? Oh, both of those are 6 centimeters. So we would say that these are the same. Now, if I can get this to come up here, it says the arcs indicate that angle X is congruent to angle M, angle Y is congruent to angle N, and angle Z is congruent to angle L, which I verified there, as well as the sides. So, since all pairs of the corresponding angles and sides are congruent, the two triangles are congruent. One congruent statement is, you can write this way, triangle XYZ is congruent to triangle MNL. That's one way to write it. But if you switch those first letters around, you can switch the second letters around. And you can see it pointing to all the different versions of what you could write as a congruent statement for these two triangles. And notice that the X matches up with the M The y will match up with the n, and the z matches up with the l in whatever order you put them in. All right, you give it a shot here. It says, determine whether the polygons shown are congruent. If so, name the corresponding parts and write a congruent statement. All right, let's look at A here. I can see that I've got a 40-degree angle, a 50-degree angle, and a 90-degree angle. That's good. And then also we have the sides where we have one tick mark, two tick marks, and three tick marks. So in A, these are definitely congruent. These are two congruent polygons. So what are some congruent statements we can write down? Well, let's match up our parts first. So we'd have angle P is congruent to angle C, angle Q is congruent to angle B, angle R is congruent to angle D. PQ and CB are congruent, QR and BD are congruent, and PR and CD are congruent. Now, to write the actual congruent statement, we've got to make sure we match up our vertices that go together. Notice which one they have. There's several versions of this. However you start your letters, in this case they started with PQR, then it forces you to set up that second one with corresponding vertices. So PQR, excuse me, triangle PQR is going to be congruent to triangle CBD. And the reason why is P goes with C. See, that's why that one's first there and that one's first there. And then, of course, you got Q, which is 40. That goes with B. That's why that one's second. And then, of course, we've got R, and that goes with D. And that's why that one's third. So those match up. Again, you could have, if you wanted, you could have triangle RQP, and then you'd have triangle DBC. You could reverse it if you wanted. Several different ones you can have there. Just make sure that those letters match up. All right, how about this one here in B? Let's take a look here. Right away, I noticed that, all right, we got angles that are all the same, right? We got all these angles that are the same, but I think some of you may notice we've got 4 feet for the shorter side of the rectangle, but on the longer side, we have 8 feet here, but we have 7 feet here. That automatically makes it not congruent. So our answer for this one's going to be, no, this isn't congruent, so we won't have to worry about writing a congruent statement. All right, let's take a look at missing measures and how we can figure those out. It says find measure of angle Q. Now, in our box over here, it says in the figure, triangle AFH is congruent to angle, or excuse me, triangle AFH is congruent to triangle QRN. So we know that these are congruent. They're telling you that, and they're actually telling you that A matches up with Q, and then F matches up with R, and that H matches up with N. Crucial that we know that, the matchup. So, according to the congruent statement, angle A and Q are corresponding angles. So that means that angle A is congruent to angle Q, which also means the measures are the same. Well, when you take a look at it, the measure of angle A is 40 degrees. So therefore, since they're equal, the measure of angle Q is 40 degrees. Well, that was simple. Let's take a look at this third one. Very similar. It says find RN. So we're trying to find the distance. How much is that? How far of a distance is that? Well, again, these are congruent figures. So FH, that segment, it corresponds to RN. So this statement or this segment matches up right here. Well, obviously, if those are the same, then we know that that's going to be 9 inches. So we would say RN is equal to 9 inches. And recall that the symbol like RN without the line over the top refers to the actual measurement of the segment with those endpoints. When you have a line over the top, we're just talking about the segment itself, not the actual distance. All right, give it a shot here. Come on back, see how you did. All right, measure of angle X. It says this quadrilateral ABCD is congruent to quadrilateral WXYZ. Find each measure. All right, we'll find what they're looking for. And I see that we have ABCD, and it looks like that's going to match up with WXYZ. All right, so I can see that, here's a congruent statement, so I can actually make it a little bit easier to see. So A matches up with W. We got B matching up with X. We've got C matching up with Y, and we've got D matching up with Z. Okay? Well, the measure of angle X, we're talking about this one right here, measure of angle X, it's got to be the same as the measure of angle B. Now, do they give that to us? Let's take a look over here. Oh, yeah, they do. So the measure of angle B, that's going to be the same as measure of angle X. All right, well, that was easy. So we would write down, the measure of angle X is equal to 145 degrees because it's the same measure as angle B. Let's take a look at D here. Same thing. We got our congruent statement. We've got our matching pieces, right? We know this. Let's make sure I get my colors on there. All right, now what are we looking for? Yx. Yx is this piece right here. I'm going to do this in black. Yx is the same as this right here, BC. So BC, well, guess what? Well, man, look how easy this is. BC is 4 meters. So now I'm looking for xy. Since it's the same thing, we would say yx is equal to 4 meters. All right, how about E? Measure of angle Y. Well, again, got her matched up. Measure of angle Y is going to match up with C here, the measure of angle C. Now, do we know what the measure of angle C is? Let me get all this out of here so you can see. We don't know that one. We don't have it. But we can get it. I do know that in a quadrilateral, if you recall, you take the number of sides minus 2 and multiply that by 180. So that'd be 4 minus 2 times 180. If you do that, you get 360 degrees. That's how many degree measures that for all four angles added up. That'd be the total of all the angles added up, 360 degrees. So what are we going to do? We're going to take that 360, and we're going to find the missing piece. We have 145, 70, and 90. Take away that from 360, and you're left with 55. And guess what? That is what it's going to be, 55 degrees. So the measure of angle Y is 55 degrees. Don't forget, you can always watch this video over again. We're all done here. Or you can, of course, read the examples in the book. Or look at the online textbook and check out some of the personal tutor videos there. This has been a wonderful Friday Shoes production.